Greetings and peace. I hope you and yours are doing well today, wherever you might be watching this from. Now, the title of today's video will be the review of The Matrix 4 Resurrections from my perspective as a Sufi Muslim and Freemason. And of course, I represent myself only and my views alone. With that said, we see in this movie the aspect of death and reincarnation, which in the Sufi aspect, they tell us in the Islamic point of view, that the life of this world is nothing but a game and a deception, but only if they knew. And that's a verse in the Holy Quran. As we see, we're taught about this life, have everything, you wake up and kind of do the same thing, repetitive motions, you don't really own anything in a system that's keeping you divided based on race, religion, gender, socioeconomic status, etc. And what kind of power can you all become if you become united and become together? As we see with Neo and Trinity, the power of love. Why is there divisions between man and woman in today's society? Lack of commitment, lack of honesty, lack of love. So if true love and free will come together, humanity can do a lot of great things. And that's what we're doing right now, as Neo and Trinity are kind of symbolized as Adam and Eve, and how humanity kind of revolves around that singularity, the descendants of Adam and Eve. And for us to become powerful, both have to come together in unison. And what it's also teaching you in the Sufi aspect, it tells you that it takes you 50,000 veils to get back to Allah. So 50,000 years it takes you through various reincarnations and lifetimes, which your traditional Islam doesn't recognize. But it's there, just like the Buddha and the suffering of the samsara. So you have to make sure that you're grounding yourself in some spiritual practice and getting yourself out of here. Now, the architect, his psychologist, who is the architect, if you look in the office, you have this blue butterfly in the back. That's the Monarch MK Ultra programming, meaning the same system that you're cooperating with is the same system that's putting you down. So find other ways of holistic approach to your health and to your life. And always be mindful of the system around you in terms of handlers and friends, and being mindful of the environment that you're in. Is it really benefiting you, or is it keeping you in a loop, not allowing you to succeed or progress in your life? So that's what we're dealing with in this life, is you have to find love, peace, unity, happiness between different genders and different peoples, races, religions, etc. in this world that's in unison right now and divided. So please be in unity with one another. Know what's there actually keeping you down and kind of manipulating you. And know the aspect of free will. Because at the end, it's your free will.